So, my dear children, the content is of our class today is present before you. So, I hope you will be very happy as we shall not do more than 5 sums, isn't it? Which makes your watch time less and you will enjoy, isn't it? Now, in question number 6, we are continuing the previous sums we had done from 1 to 5. And in question number 6, what we have, in a business, Ram and Deepak invested 3 by 5 and 2 by 5. Ram invested, see, I have marked it in red. Ram invested 3 by 5, while Deepak 2 by 5. Of, here is, lies the danger. Of the total investment, if 40,000 is the total investment, calculate the amount invested by each. So, we are going to find the amount invested by each of them, that is Ram as well as Deepak ji. Isn't it? So, okay ji, let's start. So, how to do this? See, what matters here is your presentation. If your presentation is not proper, then naturally you will be at a great loss. Solution number, question number 6. What we have? In a business, Ram and Deepak invested 3 by 5 and 2 by 5 of the total investment. Therefore, how I am going to write? I'll mention most of the data over here. You need not to fear, like total investment, I'm going to write total investment is equal to rupees 40,000, isn't it? Ram's investment is equal to 3 by 5 of 40,000. So 3 by 5 of 40,000 means when you cancel 5, 8 times 40, and we place these 3 zeros over here. 0, 0, 0. Therefore, our value will be equal to 3 multiplied by 8. 100,000 is equal to rupees 24,000. Now, what about Deepak? So, Deepak's investment will be equal to how much? Will be equal to, they have given 2 by 5 of 40,000. So 2 by 5 of 40,000, once again we will cancel it. 5, 8 times 40, and then 0, 0, 0, isn't it? So what we are going to get? We'll get 2 multiplied by 8,000 is equal to 2, 8 times 16, and then we'll put these 3 zeros once again. 1, 0, 0, 0. So, we'll have rupees 16,000 as Deepak's investment, isn't it? Okay, they're very easy. The only thing which matters is your presentation, nothing else, isn't it? Now, Geeta had 30 problems. All of us have problem in our life, isn't it? But she had problem, 30 problems for home assignment, homework. She worked 2 by 5 of them. She should have worked 5 out of 5. 5 out of 5 is your total problem in your life also. So she worked 2 by 5 of them. How many problems were still left? Have a look at this red letters. Isn't it? How many problems were still left? So let me find out how much she has worked. So, how much she has worked? So, how to mention. Again, I am going to write in the same way, number of problems. Number of problems for Geeta, isn't it? How much she had got is equal to 30. Number of problems worked out is equal to 2 by 5 of 30. She worked, see, have a look over here, 2 by 5 of them. She worked 2 by 5 of them. So 2 by 5 of 30 is equal to 5, 6 times, isn't it? 2 by 5. So 5, 6 times is equal to 6 twos are 12 problems. Number of problems that she worked out is equal to 12. Now, when she worked 12 problems, then how much is left? Therefore, number of problems left. Number of problems left will be equal to total number of problems minus she worked is equal to how much? 18 problems. She worked 18 problems. Isn't it? Now, sometimes you might also get, there are few books which states that she worked out 2 by 3 of 30. So, if 2 by 3 of 30 sums have been solved, then in that case, 3, how many times? 10 times is equal to 20 problems solved. Therefore, remaining will be 30 minus 20 is equal to 10 problems will be remaining, which she can do it if she keeps on working consistently, only then better. A picture was marked at. What is this marked at? So when you come across words like marked at or advertised at, listed at, this means they are the marked price. If you buy any article, you will find MRP, maximum retail price, which the shopkeeper will not sell it above that. So a picture was marked at rupees 90, sold at 3/4 of its MP, marked price. Okay, so let's start again. I said the presentation matters. So in number 8, what we have? Solution, marked price, write it beautifully, okay? Price is equal to rupees 90. I told you I am going to take very less time. Sale price will be equal to 3/4 of 90. Once again, let me show you that it was sold at 3/4 of its MP. So that is what I have written. Sale price is 3/4 of rupees 90. So let me cancel it. Should we? 2 times 45 is equal to 135/2 as the sale price. This should be written in rupees. Otherwise, at least half marks should be deducted, isn't it? 67 rupees 67, 1/2, if you can convert this into mixed form. Achha, this can also be written as 67.50 rupees. 67.50 means 67 rupees and 50 paise. Half rupees is 50 paise. I hope this is very, very clear. So did you see over here? These sums are very easy, isn't it? Money had sent 15 parcels of oranges. What was the total weight of the parcel? They are asking the total weight of the parcel. इफ इच वेट 10.5 kg. अच्छा, तो सिंपल, आई एम गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई 15 विथ 10.5, सिंपल. बट वंस अगेन आई सेड द प्रेजेंटेशन मैटर्स बेटर, इजंट इट. टोटल आई एम गोइंग टू राइट, टोटल नंबर ऑफ पार्सल्स इज इक्वल टू 15, वेट ऑफ ईच पार्सल इज इक्वल टू 10.5 kg. टिल नाउ आई हैवेंट यूज्ड अप माई ब्रेन. वॉट एवर दे हैड गिवन मी हियर, दे हैड गिवन मी, आई रोट द सेम थिंग. सो यू नीड नॉट टू यूज योर ब्रेन अननेसेसरी, इजंट इट. इज इक्वल टू 10.5 kg. 10.5 kg इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच? इज इक्वल टू 21 1/2 kg. टोटल वेट, दे आर आस्किंग फाइंड द टोटल वेट. The total weight is equal to how much? 15 of 15 times of 21 by 2 kg, isn't it? It's not 21 1/2, it will be 21 by 2 kg, isn't it? 21 by 2 kg, 10 2 times. Now let me cancel it. It will not get cancelled. No, it will not get cancelled. So what should we do? We should multiply it. So after multiplication, we'll get 315 by 2 kg. And when you divide it, you will get, I'm sure you will get 157.5 kg. My goodness, the parcel was very heavy. 100 kg is equal to how much? 1 quintal. Let me concentrate on question number 10. And in question number 10, what we have? The question number 10 states that, what does it state? A rope is 25 1/2 meter long. Okay. How many pieces 1.5 each of length can be cut out of it? Means this much length, 1.5 each karke. How much are you going to cut it? Means if this is a rope whose length is 25.5 meter, then they say that if you cut it in this form, okay, each having 1.5 meter, then how many can you cut out from it? So again, I am going to write solution. Total length of the rope is equal to 25 1/2 meter, which is given equal to 51 by 2 meter. I have converted this into mixed fraction. Now length of each rope is equal to how much? So length of each rope, as all of you can see, is 1.5, 1 1/2 meter, is equal to 3/2 meter. Now, number of pieces. Therefore, number of pieces will be equal to total length divided by each, which can be written as 51 by 2 divided by 3/2 meter. Therefore it will get cancelled. Finally, I am going to change this division into multiplication. 51 by 2 multiplied by 2/3, will it get cancelled? 3 17 times 51, and 2 2 will also get cancelled. Therefore finally we have 17 pieces. As I said that I am not going to exceed more than 10 sums. Therefore, Tata and Baba, before I go, I say THANK YOU 2 UELL study. Bye.